In today's video, I will take you through the concept of e-procurement, one of the key activities of upstream supply chain management. So let's begin. In the previous video on supply chain management, we had learned about what a supply chain is, what upstream and downstream supply chains are, and the activities that come under supply chain management. In today's video, we will learn about what e-procurement is, what are the activities, the applications, the benefits and limitations of e-procurement, and finally, we'll also go through the current trends in e-procurement. Procurement refers to the processes for acquiring the various resource inputs to the primary activities of an organization. It covers all the activities needed to obtain items from a supplier, so therefore it basically talks about the whole purchases cycle. E-procurement is therefore used to describe the electronic methods used in every stage of the procurement process, from identification of the organization's requirements through to the payments. This can be broken down into the stages of e-sourcing, e-purchasing, and e-payment. So let's have a look at each of these. E-sourcing covers all electronic methods for finding new suppliers and establishing contracts. Not only can e-sourcing help save administrative time and money, it also enables companies to identify new suppliers and source resources more easily. Issuing electronic invitations to tenders and requests for quotations reduces administration overheads, potentially costly errors caused by data entry, and a reduction in the response time. E-purchasing covers product selection and product ordering. Online buying and selling reduces administration time as well as overheads. The features of e-purchasing system includes electronic catalogs for core and standard products, recurring requisitions or shopping lists for regularly purchased items, something that you will also observe as retail shoppers when you are shopping online through various apps like Amazon, Grofers, Big Basket, etc. Electronic purchase orders dispatched automatically through an extranet to suppliers, and detailed MIS or management information system capturing and sorting data effectively. Having a well-designed web interface goes to ensuring high user satisfaction. E-payment includes tools such as electronic invoicing and electronic fund transfers. E-payment can make the payment processes a lot more efficient for the purchaser as well as for the supplier by reducing cost and by reducing errors. Now let's have a look at the applications that an organization can use to manage its upstream supply chain, beginning with EDI, that is Electronic Data Interchange. This involves the organization linking its systems to those of its suppliers, enabling faster and a much more efficient paperless ordering. This improves the speed, effectiveness, and accuracy in fulfillment of orders. Use of internet to choose the most reliable and cost-effective suppliers from a larger geographical span, and disintermediation through which the organization may be able to buy its supplies online directly from a wholesaler than a retailer, therefore saving money. Now moving on to seeing the benefits and limitations of e-procurement, the more the procurement process can be automated, the better it would be for the organization in terms of realizing financial benefits. Labor cost would reduce and so will the inventory holding cost. Production and sales should be higher due to more accurate monitoring of demand and greater ordering accuracy. There would be greater control over inventory, quicker ordering, and it would be easier to implement lean management and just-in-time manufacturing systems. The firm may benefit from a wider choice of suppliers. There would also be greater financial transparency and accountability. Now, there are a few potential risks and limitations of e-procurement. The system encounters risks such as organizational risks, where employees may be reluctant and skeptical to accept the new procurement system. Technological risk in terms of software and hardware choice, the implementation and the functioning of the same. Intangible benefits, difficult to estimate. Now, while tangible benefits are easy to forecast, such as cost and financial benefit, intangible benefits such as customer satisfaction, quality, and improved reputation or goodwill may be difficult to estimate. Now, e-procurement might not be the best solution for customized and specialist products because of the nature and the complexities involved in the selection of the products. And finally, e-procurement needs high level of cybersecurity. Hence, companies need to, or organizations need to invest in mitigating those risks and develop a secure platform. But in general, the benefits outweigh the limitations of e-procurement, and in today's context especially, it definitely has more relevance. The current trends in e-procurement include big data analytics, through which procurement organizations can predict and improve business performance. Procurement analytics can help and enable data-driven decision-making. Internet of Things will help improve catalog content and spend management. It works as an enabler, empowering companies gain visibility into their spend analysis. Blockchain is a technology that creates a decentralized record of all transactions in a network and acts as a powerful enabler in the hands of procurement teams of organizations. In terms of procurement, cloud usage helps manage and control spending. Through cloud procurement systems, organizations can efficiently handle processes of requisitioning, sourcing, procuring, and handling services. E-procurement software manages contracts, analyzes, spends, and purchases goods. Platforms enhance engagements between vendors and consumers to improve efficiency and accountability and help reduce the total cost. For example, for government-related projects, large-scale procurement is routed through the GEM platform, enabling time and cost efficiencies. I hope you found this video informative. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to learn more concepts in management. Here's to happy learning, now and always.